Welcome back to Let's Play Bloodborne for Katie. We're back in the Nightmare Frontier, just gonna finish up this awful, awful level that I hate in this video. Finally get rid of that Bell Maiden. She's just a brief walk away from that part of the swamp that we left off in last time. And now I'm getting a little lost, but trying to make it back up to that ledge I was on when Patches came and pushed us off. Which at this point I then realized, oh, it's back there. Very easy to get lost in this place. How nightmarish. There it is. Except I gotta go around to get up. They can't make it easy for you, can they? I mean, it is from software. They quite literally don't want to. The challenge is the point. Here we go. Now we can finally get whatever that fucking item was that he teased us with. Oh, and it's just some... just some chalice ritual materials I'm not gonna use. Okay, thanks, Patches. I should have taken your advice and not wasted my time. Like with the Forbidden Woods, I'm sure there's stuff I missed in this run-through of the Nightmare Frontier, but like... again, like with the Forbidden Woods, I hate this level, so I don't want to come back to it. Also, a new sea rune. This one adds rapid poison resistance. Which... is good for this part. Yeah, rapid poison, or toxic, as it's known in Dark Souls. You know, it's pretty dangerous, but it's also kind of rare. Like, you don't really... there are not many enemies who can inflict it on you, and not really until the end of the game. So... or, you know, close to the end of the game. Past the halfway point. So, you know, like, technically it can fuck you up worse than slow poison. Faster than slow poison, but like... you know, with the way that this game shakes out for me each time, I usually have more trouble with slow poison because it happens earlier when I'm less prepared, you know? Like the blood-starved beast does not rapid poison you, but that gave me a lot more trouble than these slugs, you know? Even on this playthrough. And with this outdoor section of the swamp that you do have to trudge through in order to get to the boss, that I usually end up trudging through to get to the boss, there's these islands everywhere, which helps make it a little easier for you to get around. Okay. All right, then. There we go. Rock over London, rock on Chicago, Arby's. We have the meats. And here we go. Yep. When you got two of these giant lost childs throwing shit at you. Giant lost children? It can get pretty hectic there. Anyway, at this point, I'm gonna stop and start changing my clothes to max out my my frenzy resistance, because up ahead will be our first encounter with the enemy that I have spent the whole game telling you I am very scared of. They're called Winter Lanterns. And I'm gonna warn you, this thing is freaky as hell. Every time I have to fight one of these in this game, I make the most embarrassing faces, and I whimper, and I just, like, I go clammy white, my hands start sweating. They scare the hell out of me. But alright, we're maxed out on our frenzy, we got sedative. I'm gonna top up my health in a minute. 'Cause there it is. Okay. Here we go. Oh god, oh god, god. Okay. Die, die, die! Okay, okay, good. Now just drink it. Drink the sedative, drink the sedative, drink it. Whew. We lived. And for your troubles, those things actually drop some of the best blood gems in the game. The cursed blood gems, I believe I mentioned them earlier, they have some of the best boosts to your physical attack, but they come with a significant drawback. Some more significant than others. In this case, it whatever weapon you put it on depletes your stamina by, like, plus 1.4% more or some shit, which is downright negligible. Some of the curses are a lot worse, like they'll, you know, steadily drain your health, or they'll, like, completely nerf your weapon durability. But some of them are fine, so I am gonna be putting that cursed blood gem on my saw spear. And just leaving a little warning about the Winter Lantern there. Yes, I realize I hyped that up a lot and then managed to kill it very quickly. That's mainly just because I've been burned too many times by this fucking game before. And I did not want to have to go all the way back to the lamp and come back again just to fight the scary brain lady. Those things do scare me. And that right there was, So with all the gestures in this game, you can do them from the menu, or if you're standing still and press the X button while, like, gesturing the controller in a way, you can do the emote that way. So a couple of times throughout this game, you're gonna see me accidentally do an emote when I'm trying to, like, skip dialogue or, you know, pick up an item that I'm not close enough to, and that's why, because there's this, like, maybe they thought it was supposed to be convenient, but I only ever trigger it by accident. I'm screaming there because that sound you can hear through the wall there is the voice of the Winter Lanterns. Another reason they scare me, their song is very scary. The way they sing, chills the bones. But yes, they, I killed it off too fast to really get into why they're so freaky, but beyond their just visual design. But they inflict frenzy upon you just by looking at you. They grow giant arms out of their brain heads that grab you, and then they have you in a grab while they're still frenzying you, and they bite your face with, like, a dozen mouths inside of their heads. And also, they're one of the enemies that, when they start inflicting frenzy upon you, you know, even if you kill them, it does not start to go down the way it did with the Gardens of Eyes or the church wardens with those crosses. It'll just keep building up and up until you get frenzied, so you gotta have sedatives on hand. You gotta either have sedatives on hand or be prepared to get yourself to max health so that you don't instantly die when the frenzy bursts. But, would you look at that? We just unlocked a shortcut so we can skip the whole level. Thank fucking god. Because I hate this level. It really, it just, like, everything... Everything comes together into a perfect shit sandwich in this level for me. It's easy to get lost. There's a lot of hard enemies. There's a big poison swamp. There's winter lanterns in it. Including one in the poison swamp, which I ran away from last episode. But we'll soon be finished here. All we gotta do is beat this boss. How hard could it be? Get the fuck out of here! Yeah. Give me a blood gem. Fuck you. So, yeah. The part of the swamp that Patches pushes you down into, I believe actually leads out here, if you were to follow it the way I started going before I ran into the Winter Lantern and was like, nope, 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 nope. So, he actually kinda does push you closer to the boss fight, but... If you go toward the boss fight, you're gonna be fucked. Speaking of which, where's the boss? Oh, there she is! It's Amygdala! The big one! We've already seen some of what the smaller buddies could do, and she has a lot of those same, she has that same laser attack, too, where she grows the eyes. Ow! But she has a lot more attacks with her many big, long limbs. And this fight, depending on the build you have, can be really easy or really fucking hard. So me, as a melee build, I have to resort to alternative methods, since the normal way I would try to go about fighting this boss with my build would be extremely inefficient, i.e. just keep attacking her heavily armored legs, which don't take a lot of damage, which would make this take forever. Why I came here with a bunch of bone marrow ashes and a hunter pistol, so I could keep shooting her big dumb head. Because the head is the weak spot, and also I fucking love that she rips off her own arms and tries to hit you with them. It's so goofy. And it's also badass the way they just spout blood from the stumps over and over again. At this point though, in this first attempt, I kind of choked at this point. Almost running out of bullets and running out of bone marrow ashes to buff my shots, so... Her slam attacks also are very dangerous. A lot of damage. But yeah, if you wanted to be a chump about this fight, you could just... plink away at her legs. And try to dodge all of her stomps while baiting out some head slam attacks so you can get that big meaty brain. But I find coming here with a gun is much better. Like, imagine if I was actually doing a full blood tinge build, how easy this boss would be. And this is just a PSA for all you kids out there in video land. Make sure if you need an item in your quick menu, don't try to put it on there while there's a guy who can come and hit you. I still wish this game had an actual pause feature. At least in offline mode. Like, I know I'm playing online, and so you, like, pausing would mess up, like, the co-op and PvP sort of stuff. But, like, you know, if you can play it offline, you should be able to pause. Like, what if the phone rings? Whoa! Yeah, see? Fucking 5 damage. On its legs. As opposed to 100 damage with a gun on its head. Ah, I should have just swung at the head. that's the issue with the hunter pistol, is it kind of tends to miss a lot. Or at least, it has the potential to miss a lot if you, like, aren't careful about when you decide to shoot. Because, you know, while you're locked on, if you know, guy's head you're trying to shoot is in one place, you know, by the time you get through the firing animation, it might be somewhere else entirely. Unless you want to get your monocular out, it's like you gotta lock on to shoot things, because it's not really, the game doesn't really have, like, third-person, you know, shooter controls. Another cool thing about the amygdala is that you could see pretty well in the cutscene where we got whisked away to the lecture building is that they have two thumbs on each hand, like one on either side of the fingers. Which is, the same, which, for one thing, is very creepy, but also it's the same as the robots in the Zone of the Enders games. Jehuti and Anubis, all the orbital frames, that you pile around in those games, which are based on Egyptian mythology. Big, flying space mechs. They also have, each of them have two thumbs on each hand. Which I think is neat. Yeah, you can eventually stagger the legs to do more damage, but, you know, your actual hits on the legs are not gonna do much. Another thing about Zone of the Enders is that even though all the robots have faces, the cockpit of the robot is in the robot's dick. It's literally a cockpit. Anyway. There's amygdala gone. R.I.P. Amy G. Loran is a tragic land that was devoured by the sands. Tragedy that struck this ailing land is said to have its roots in the Scourge of the Beast. Some have made the dreaded extrapolation that Yharnam may be next. Nah, we're fine. Right, Katie? It's fine. Anyway. Amygdala and this whole level are completely optional. But if you're doing the chalices, I believe Loran is one of the story chalices, so you do have to come here for that.